गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीबॉडी, माइसेल्फ यश यादव एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द एंटीरियर एब्डोमिनल वॉल अलोंग विद दैट द पेरिटोनियल कैविटी. तो लाइक द एंटीरियर एब्डोमिनल वॉल जो होती है हमारी, लाइक इसमें सिक्स लेयर होते हैं बेसिकली. द स्पीयर मोस्ट लेयर इज द स्किन. लाइक व्हेन वी रिफ्लेक्ट द स्किन, लाइक वी विल फाइंड अ लेयर ऑफ सुपरफिशियल फाशिया विच इज डिवाइडेड लाइक बिलो द लेवल ऑफ द अम्बिलिकल इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू लेयर्स. वन इज द superficial layer, that is the fascia of camper, and below which we have the membranous layer, that is the fascia of scarpa. Okay, and when we reflect this fascia, like superficial fascia, then we will found the muscles of the anterior abdominal wall. And remember, like the anterior abdominal wall is the only exception in the body where we found the muscle just beneath the superficial fascia. Okay, so like if we talk about the lateromedial side, lateromedial, then the most superficial muscle is the external oblique muscle. This is the external oblique muscle. I am reflecting this, and then we will found the internal oblique, and then the transverse abdominis muscle. And just beneath the transverse abdominis muscle, like this is the fascia of transversalis. Yeah, transversalis fascia. Okay. And just beneath it, we have the extra peritoneal fat or membranes, and then the peritoneum. Okay. And remember, the aponeurosis of these muscles actually comes in the medial plane and covers the muscle which is present in the medial side, that is the rectus abdominis. And like this is the aponeurosis, also called as the rectus. See, and just beneath it we have this rectus abdominis muscle. Like this is the rectus abdominis muscle, and beneath this we have the fascia transversalis, again the peritoneal membrane and the peritoneum. Like we are reflecting this. Okay. Now this is like this. This is a liver which is covered by the diaphragm. Okay, which is the only muscular tendinous structure which divides the peritoneal cavity and the thoracic cavity in our body. Like the liver. Okay, now one important thing, the peritoneum होता है हमारी body में, वो दो तरह का होगा. Like the peritoneum होता है parietal peritoneum and visceral peritoneum. जो parietal peritoneum होता है basically, एक्चुअली क्या होता है कि पूरी बॉडी में दो हिस्से होते हैं. एक होता है वेंट्रल मीजोगैस्ट्रियम, एक होता है पोस्टीरियर डोर्सल मीजोगैस्ट्रियम. तो वेंट्रल मीजोगैस्ट्रियम एक्चुअली लिवर को एंटीरियर एब्डोमिनल वॉल से जोड़ के रखता है, लाइक विद द हेल्प ऑफ फ्लेशिफॉर्म लिगामेंट एंड ट्रायंगुलर एंटीरियर एंड लेटरल ट्रायंगुलर लिगामेंट, सुपीरियर एंड इन्फीरियर कोरोनरी लिगामेंट लाइक वाइज. ठीक है ना. सो लाइक वी आर रिफ्लेक्टिंग द डायफ्राम एंड दिस स्ट्रक्चर. Let me show you. This structure is called the ligamentum teres, which is a remnant of the umbilical vein. Okay. This is the liver. This is the right lobe of the liver. This is the left lobe of the liver. And just like when we reflect the liver, we will found the gall bladder. This is the gall bladder, and this is the fundus of the gall bladder, which lies at the level of the tip of the ninth costal cartilage, and now what happens is, like in the case of cholecystitis, when we press on the tip of the ninth costal cartilage, there will be a tenderness on the face of the patient, and this find is called the Murphy's sign. Okay, cholecystitis matlab inflammation of the gallbladder. And okay, now this structure is called the stomach. This is the fundus of the stomach. Okay, now this is the esophageal portion where the esophagus connect with the the cardiac portion of the stomach. Here is the cardiac notch, and here is the orifices, which is the cardiac orifices, which is covered by a sphincter called the cardiac sphincter. This is a type of a physiological sphincter. This is the fundus, this is the greater curvature, this is the lesser curvature, and this is the pyloric portion. And this hardening part is the pyloric orifices, like pyloric canal, you know, pylorus, like this. And this pyloric sphincter is present. This is pyloric sphincter, is a type of anatomical sphincter. Okay. And this pyloric sphincter or pyloric orifices actually connects with the first part of the duodenum. Like duodenum is divided into four parts. One is the shorter part actually. First part like this running, which is actually connected with the pyloric portion of the stomach. And then the second part, which is descending portion, descend up to the level of the lower border of L3. Then the transverse portion, and then ascending portion of the duodenum, which actually communicate with the jejunum. And then further, ileum, which actually totally comprises the small intestine. Now let's talk about the arterial supply of the stomach. Like the this is the lesser curvature of the stomach. It is supplied by the left and right gastric artery. And left gastric artery is a direct branch from the
celiac
trunk. Okay. and another one is the right gastric artery, which is a direct branch from the proper hepatic artery. And the greater curvature is supplied by the right and left gastro omental artery. Remember, omental means like related to peritoneum, also known as so gastro omental. The right gastro omental artery is a branch of gastroduodenal, and left is a branch of splenic. Okay, and the fundus portion is supplied by the 5th to 7th small branches from the splenic artery directly. Okay, which is itself is a branch of the celiac trunk. Okay, like I have cut it this pyloric region, so the duodenum has been cut off. This is the first part of the duodenum, right? I am reflecting the stomach. This structure is the pancreas. And just beneath the to the fundus of the stomach, it lies the spleen, okay? Which the artery supply of the spleen is splenic artery, which is a branch of celiac trunk. Okay. And this structure is called the greater omentum, which actually descends from the greater curvature of the stomach. And remember, the stomach and the liver is connected with the help of a lesser omentum. And like two ligaments actually form the lesser omentum. One is the hepatogastric ligament, another one is the hepatoduodenal ligament, like this, together form the lesser omentum. And beneath to this we have this omental foramen or epicoid foramen or foramen of Wilson. Okay, greater omentum, and this is the jejunum and this is the ileum. Like the major difference how we identify actually is the lumen. The major difference is lumen. Like the lumen of the jejunum is thick while the lumen of the ileum is thin. And along with that we also find some arteries, like in this mesentery. Like this is the mesentery portion. Here we found the arcuate arteries. Like in jejunum we have 1 to 2 arcuate arteries, while in ileum we have 2 to 6 arcuate arteries. And remember the vasa recta, in the jejunum the vasa recta is greater or larger, while in ileum it is smaller. And this is the ileum, which communicate with the cecum portion and form the ileocecal junction. And at this junction only we will found a structure called the appendix or vermiform appendix, which is a rudimentary structure in our body, a vestigial organ. And what is appendectomy? Appendectomy? The surgical removal of the appendix. Okay. Like at this ileocecal junction only, the ascending colon begins. And at the level of this liver, like the below the right lobe of the liver and superior to the right kidney, we have the right hepatic flexure. And remember, right hepatic flexure se starting hoti hai hamari transverse colon ki. And remember, transverse colon hum log ka straight run nahi karta hai is tarah se, mostly ascending form mein run karta hai. Isiliye kehte hain, aur haan, jo ek minute, aur is tarah se run karega, and up to the level of this spleen, where it is known as the splenic flexure. Actually the transverse colon lie over the spleen, and where it take a turn, that turn is known as the splenic flexure. And differences about this flexure, like the hepatic flexure is not suspended by anything, it is free, while the splenic flexure is suspended by a fold of a peritoneum called the phrenicocolic ligament. Okay, now the artery supply, if we talk about like the hepatic flexure, the artery supply is the right colic artery, which is a branch of superior mesenteric artery, while this splenic flexure supplies with the
left colic artery, branch of inferior mesenteric artery.
Okay. And remember one vertebral level is the hepatic flexure hota hai wo lie karta hai the level of L2, while the splenic level splenic flexure lie at the level of T12. Like isliye maine kaha ki wo ascend karta hai directly, matlab actual transverse nahi, matlab straight form mein run nahi karta hai. And then from this splenic flexure we have this descending colon, and then it continues in the form of sigmoid colon, like S-shaped structure, that is why it is known as sigmoid colon. And then the rectum and the anal canal and the anus.
Okay,
this is the complete structure, the peritoneum cavity. This is the vitreous, which we have just discussed. So thank you very much.